Welcome to Whisky.com, where fine spirits meet. My name is Lüning, Horst Lüning, and I'm the master taster of Whisky.com. And today we have the Glengoyne Cask Strength here on my cask. It's batch number 3. 58.2% ABV, quite strong, and in maturation in sherry casks. I tasted before, long before, a 12-year-old cask strength from Glengoyne, but this bottle is long gone, and I'm afraid this one carries no age statement, so the supply of casks at Glengoyne is quite low. At Glengoyne, they use no peat for the production. This is their unique selling proposition. And Robbie Hughes, the distillery manager, says digestive biscuits, ripe bananas, and a hint of pepper. This is the taste of Scotland's slowest distillation, bottled as tradition insists at cask strength, un-chillfiltered like every Glengoyne. The amber hue is created by thyme and oak. Nothing more, so they do not color their whiskey. Nurtured, then matured. Natural, color, unchill filtered, and cask strength. In hand-selected oak cask. Well, every cask is hand-selected. up to 6 years from oak forest to Highland distillery. That is how long it takes before sherry casks are finally ready to receive our spirit. However, the journey has just begun. Next, time and wood work together within the cool darkness of our traditional earth-floored warehouses. Well, I visited Glengoyne in 2013, I think. Here's the video from my visit to the distillery. And they have torn down, they have wrecked the old or part of the old warehouses with the earth floor. And build new ones where they stock the whiskey in cask on pallets. So with a forklift, it's quite easy, quite cheap. And a lot of whiskey is going into these taller buildings, and the old dunnage warehouses with the earth-floored floor. You typically store the whiskey 3 casks high, and it's a lot of tedious work to remove the casks out from that warehouse. So old warehouses. Here, away from sight, the amber hue and rich mouthfeel develop along with a finish that lasts and lasts. Our whiskey is then carefully bottled at cask strength to preserve the rich, bold flavors. All in good time. And here in the bottom you see 6 signatures of employees, responsible employees, for the patience, a still man, unpeated, the mash man, natural color, the malt master, oak cask, the cooper, Sierra Spain, maturation, the warehouse man, and tradition, distillery manager. So I tasted this whiskey a few minutes ago, and I found out that if you dilute this whiskey by only a few percent, perhaps down to, I had 52%, it had lost a lot of its aroma. So this whiskey is especially made for being enjoyed in cask length. But I do not taste whiskey above 50%. Well, it depends. I went up to 52.8 last time, but I do not want to go higher, because this will paralyze my taste buds. But this one is the last I have today. So the first time in my life I will taste at 58.2% ABV. Full vanilla. Vanilla sauce. Over cream, toffee cream. red fruits. And a little oak is developing. And there is an uncommon smell in this whiskey, like the damp and old and dark and heavy air inside a Dunwich warehouse. It said a little peppery, but no, I don't feel any pepper. Well, this is heavy alcohol, but well balanced with the taste. Sherry, sweet, sugary sweet. Red fruits and the ripe bananas. No, not really. The aftertaste quite long. The alcohol has forced the aromas into my tongue, into my mouth. So this carries for long. So tasting in really high ABV has an impact in your mouth. There's a different taste in this whiskey. Darker, damper. Like moisty soil. Yeah. Well, this is best savored neat. No water, of course, no ice. And then, well, if you add water, it will immediately reduce in intensity. And I think those casks were selected to be savored neat, not diluted. Thank you for watching Whisky.com. There's more to come. Stay tuned and feel free to share this video with your friends and look up those bottles in our database at Whisky.com.